amazing, aren't they? And if you're like me, you probably wonder how they get up into the air and stay there. Well, despite human ingenuity, there are sadly those rare occasions when things don't go as planned. Accidents do happen, and that's when the AAIB, the Air Accidents Investigation Branch, swings into action.
Good morning, Air Accidents Investigation Branch.
As part of the Department for Transport, the AAIB is otherwise completely independent of any other body, such as the Civil Aviation Authority, the CAA, or the police. Now, I'm joined by Keith Conradi, Chief Inspector of Air Accidents. So, Keith, can you just describe the role of the AAIB?
The role of the AAIB is to investigate all civil accidents in the United Kingdom, to identify the causes, and to make safety recommendations intended to prevent reoccurrence.
And do you need to apportion blame?
Absolutely not. We do not apportion blame or liability. We're simply about conducting thorough investigations, identifying any safety action that may have been taken, and making safety recommendations. And we make sure that all our findings are addressed to interested parties, such as manufacturers, operators, or regulators, whether that be also national or international.
So how does the AAIB go about its work? Well, if you haven't guessed already, I'm here at the Farnborough Air Show, and it's one of the biggest air shows in the world. And it was no coincidence bumping into Keith, because the AAIB's headquarters are really close by. And quite a few of Keith's colleagues are here too. He's put me on to David Miller to explain how the AAIB works.
Well, all our investigators are inspectors of air accidents, and they fall into three disciplines: operations, engineering, and flight recorders.
Marcus, what does your job involve?
My job's to look at all the circumstances of the flight, where it came from, where it's going, who was on board, and also to contact as many witnesses as possible and take written statements from them. And also looking at the radar recordings and the RT that when the pilot was in communication with air traffic control.
And do you have a police service background?
No, all the operations inspectors at the AAIB are ex-commercial pilots or test pilots and hold a current airline transport pilot's licence.
Marcus told me that he and his colleagues still take control of passenger airliners on a regular basis to stay in touch with the flying environment and to keep abreast of current technology. And he's very kindly put me on to one of his fellow investigators, Andrew Robinson, a senior inspector engineering. So Andrew, as an engineering inspector, what do you do at an accident site?
The ground marks that the aircraft made when it hits the ground can often tell us things. For example, did it hit in a steep angle of attitude? Was it sort of shallow? And that can help us to determine whether it was under control, out of control. And of course, we also need to establish whether or not all the four corners of the aircraft are there. If not, then we're looking perhaps at a structural failure.
And I imagine that aviation technology is changing at a rapid rate. How do you keep abreast of it all?
We go on courses provided by the manufacturer, and they give us a sort of general idea of the what's happening. We then get deep into the detail in whatever area we happen to be steered after the initial investigations.
And do you need a pilot's licence?
We are encouraged to go and get ourselves a private pilot's licence, and that enables us to fly small, light aircraft.
The third discipline is Inspector of Air Accidents Flight Recorders. I'm off to meet Mark Ford. Mark, slightly odd job title that you've got, Inspector Air Accidents Flight Recorders. What exactly do you do?
We're engineers that specialise in the recovery and interpretation of recorded data from devices such as the flight data recorder and cockpit voice recorder that are required to be equipped to passenger aircraft, and also other devices such as GPS systems and digital cameras that you may find on board smaller private aircraft.
I asked David Miller how a typical investigation would be conducted.
Well, when an accident or serious incident occurs, one of the principal inspectors will make a decision on how the AIB are going to respond. And most of these accidents occur to small aircraft. And if it's appropriate to send a team out, that team will consist of an operations inspector, an engineer, and a flight recorder specialist.
Once the engineering inspector is satisfied that all the perishable evidence has been recorded or preserved, he'll usually ask the engineering support team to recover the wreckage here to the hangar at the AAIB's headquarters. When the other team members return to HQ, they hold a briefing chaired by the chief inspector. Now, the briefing's attended by other inspectors, and the scope and depth of the investigation is decided. Andrew, talk me through what happens next.
Well, the wreckage is brought back to our hangar here at Farnborough, and while our flight data recorder colleagues are looking at all the electronic data, we would look at the systems of the aircraft, the structure, to try and find out if there'd been any failure that might have occurred in the air and precipitated the accident. And anything we find difficult to explain, we could submit to metallurgists to try and establish whether there was a material defect or perhaps metal fatigue.
Irrespective of the size of the accident, the same principles apply. The bigger the accident, the greater the pressure on the AAIB. Despite this though, the AAIB are adamant that there's no substitute for a thorough examination of the wreckage, both on site and here in their hangar. The AAIB fully conforms to internationally agreed standards. Inspectors are often deployed on foreign investigations, feeding back information to UK manufacturers and regulators so they can take appropriate action. So David, we know who the AAIB is and what it does, but what happens to all that information?
Well, in fact, we publish a detailed report on every accident and serious incident we investigate. We publish them online or in hard copy. And where there's a need for instant action, we publish an interim bulletin to get safety information out, or where there's public demand.
Keith, can you just sum up the AAIB for me?
The AAIB is all about teamwork. Whether it's groups of two or three for a small event, or maybe dozens for a larger accident. As I said at the beginning, it's not about apportioning blame. It's about understanding the underlying causes of accidents and preventing future loss of life. I'd like to think we've built a reputation for this, a reputation for accuracy, thoroughness, and independence.
Thank you, Keith. Demand for air travel is due to increase year on year until 2025. The UK has one of the best aviation safety records in the world, and the Air Accidents Investigation Branch is committed to ensure that that record continues to improve. And I personally find that very reassuring.